Today we'll discuss about snake bite. In India alone, it has been estimated that as many as 2.8 million people are bitten by snakes, and 46,900 people die from snake bite every year in India. Okay, so snake bite envenomation is very commonly seen in the rural population, and snake directly injects the venom to the body by biting the victim, or sometimes rarely it can spit the venom out of from the mouth. Okay, there are around more than 3,000 species of snakes detected all over the world by WHO. In that, 250 species are dangerous. They produce envenomation in the human being. We'll see there are four main groups of snakes. There are four main families of snakes: Elapidae, Viperidae, Hydrophidae, and Crotalidae. In Elapidae, we have two common snakes, cobra and crates. Nobody will miss a cobra because it has got a peculiar spectacle mark on the hood. And crate is very classical, it has got rings over the body. Okay, Viperidae is the next common thing that has got a major snake, that is Russell's viper. Hydrophidae is classically sea snake. It is not very common in our area, but once you encounter a bite in the sea area, you can get sea snake bites. Crotalidae is classically pit vipers. These are the major four groups of snake. Remember, cobra, crate, viper, and sea snakes are the most important poisonous snakes in India. Okay, now we'll see. First, we'll discuss about the cobra bite. Cobra venom mainly affects, it's a neurotoxic venom. It mainly affects our nervous system. The clinical features of cobra bite is patient presents with weakness, that predominantly muscle weakness. Patient can have paralysis, respiratory paralysis, ophthalmoplegia, weakness of pharyngeal muscles. The most important clinical finding in cobra bite will be ophthalmoplegia. Note that we have to remember that we all think that king cobra is more poisonous than normal cobra, but most of the times it's venomous, but it is most of the times the amount of venom injected to the victim is very less comparing to normal cobra. So remember, in cobra bite, your neurological system is predominantly affected. Mainly patient presents with ptosis as a first sign, then they can have other muscle paralysis, then they can have respiratory paralysis. All these things indicates a neurological problem in the cobra bite. Next important snake is viper. Okay, viper is mainly seen in cold areas. You can see viper has got a triangular head, and viper venom mainly affects the blood. Okay, blood and kidneys. Common clinical findings: patient bleeds from everywhere. Patient can have epistaxis, subconjunctival hemorrhage, and ecchymotic patches, bleeding from gums, bleeding through urine. All these things are the most important clinical finding. Remember, viper mainly affects your blood, that produces bleeding tendencies. Patient can present with the first, the important clinical finding may be patient may be passing red urine, and other clinical findings in viper bite may be nephrotoxicity. It can produce renal failure, mainly hum nose pit viper, that produces severe renal failure and prolonged renal failure. You can see local reactions are another important finding. Mainly this viper type of bite, viper venom, produces severe local swelling, local edema, compartment syndrome. All these things are very common in viper bite. Rarely these bites can produce arrhythmia, and any snake bite can produce arrhythmia because of fear. Fear-induced tachycardia, arrhythmias are very common, and viper bite can produce arrhythmias and hypotension. The third important snake in our country is crate bite. Crate bite is, again, it produces neurotoxicity, that also can have same features like a cobra bite. Okay, now we'll see what are the investigations. Quickly we'll see what are the investigation. The common investigation done in emergency room is we see a complete blood count. So whenever we have an inflammation in our body, even in snake bite also, leukocytosis can be there. And prothrombin type, PTINR, is one of the most important clinical investigation you have to do in emergency room. Prothrombin time can be elevated in viper bite. So remember that PTINR can be elevated in viper bite. APTT also can be sometimes elevated, and you get a low fibrinogen, that indicates disseminated intravascular coagulation. Remember, PTINR can be elevated, Rarely APTT can be elevated. If both are elevated, sometimes you get a very low fibrinogen level. That indicates DIC. And prolonged clotting time can be done in a like a normal settings. You can see what is a clotting time. If it is prolonged, you should suspect a bleeding disorder. And many parts of the world where all this PTNR is not available, you can do a 20 minutes whole blood clotting time. There is also a primitive test, but it is very useful where you don't have a PTNR test. And another investigation you should do in emergency room is urea creatinine and ECG. We have already discussed. Patient can have acute MI, patient can have arrhythmias, patient can have hypertension, shock, all these things. So ECG and ECG monitoring is very important. Okay. Now we will see what is the treatment given for a snake bite victim. Okay. If the patient is outside, if you are not a doctor or if you are a paramedic, you have to follow these rules. No right rules. No means you should not put a tourniquet, you should not put electricity, like electric shock should not be given on the area, and you should not cut the wound and excuse the wound. So don't do tourniquet, electrotherapy, cutting at the wound site. Just clean the wound, that's all. Okay. Then right we'll discuss. Right is reassure the patient. You make understand the patient that sometimes snake may not be poisonous snake, but because of fear itself he can develop so many problems. So reassure the patient. Patient may be poisonous, non-poisonous. Even if it is poisonous, if you are taking the patient in right time to hospital, he can improve very fast. Then immobilize the limb. That is the next important thing. That R is reassurance, I is immobilize the limb. Then GH, that is get to hospital immediately. Last one is T, that is tell the doctor about the clinical symptoms. So no right is the first step as a emergency medical technician or a layman. You follow these rules. Okay. Now we'll see what are the basic cares we give for a snake bite after the first few minutes. So you try to take the patient to a nearest hospital. His limb should be immobilized. The bitten area should be immobilized. So we'll put a small splint, put a small wooden piece, and you try to apply elastoscrape bandage or some a piece of cloth around the wound and up to the knee joint. Suppose it's in the lower limb, up to the knee joint, you put a elastoscrape bandage so that the venom will not be venom will not pass to the blood very fast, but the blood supply will not be cut. When you put a tourniquet, what happens is the complete blood supply to the limb can be sometimes reduced and patient can have ischemic limb. To prevent that, we don't put a tourniquet, we just put a elastoscrape bandage and try to prevent superficial flow. So we'll discuss how to put a elastoscrape bandage. So keep a wooden piece for immobilize the limb. Put the elastoscrape bandage just above the wound, and suppose it is in the lower limb up to knee joint, here to put and immobilize and prevent the superficial flow of the venom. Okay. Now we'll see once the patient reaches the hospital, what is the next step? Okay. Now the doctor will be seeing the patient, and he will identify whether the patient has got an envenomating bite or a normal bite. So for that you need a fang marks. Normally all snakes, when they bite, they have two fang marks, two drop of bloods. Okay. So that will be very clear. But remember that crate bite will not have such a good fang marks, because it's very small fangs, so that may not produce a fang marks. But all other snakes will produce fang marks, and you can see local swelling, you can see local tenderness, redness, and lymphangitis can be there. Sometimes lymphadenopathy also can be there. Patient can have abdominal pain. Once you understand that patient has got an envenomation, snake bite envenomation, you may do some investigation like PTNR, all these things, and you look for ptosis, all these things. You identify that patient has got a venomous bite, then you go for definitive treatment. Definitive treatment in snake bite is anti-snake venom. In India, we are getting polyvalent anti-snake venom. We are mainly targeting the four major snakes which is seen in India, that we have already discussed. So these venoms will cover only four major groups of snakes in India. So that's why it is called as polyvalent anti-snake venom. So polyvalent anti-snake venom should be given only according to the clinical suspicion. Suppose you have seen the snake and snake has bitten, but if there is no clinical finding of envenomation, it may not be required to give a anti-snake venom. But if the patient has got a clinical finding which suggestive of anti-snake envenomation, it should be administered. So ASV, we'll discuss ASV. ASV, one vial should be diluted in 10 ml of normal saline, give over 10 minutes. The full dose of the ASV, whatever we decide, normally we give 10 vials in the first, as a first regime, that should be given over. So one vial should be given in 10 ml of saline over 10 minutes. So it may, you are planning for 10 vials, it may take 100 minutes to give, 1.5 hours to finish the infusion protocol. Till then, the doctor has to be with the patient, because any time during the infusion, patient can develop anaphylaxis or allergy. In case of allergy or anaphylaxis, you have to stop the infusion, but no need of giving a test dose before giving the transfusion. So no test dose, minimum vial should be started, 10 vials as a initial bolus, that should be given over 1.5 hours. Then you go for rechecking the or re-evaluating the patient for envenomation. Okay. Now, if suppose the patient develops a neurotoxic bite, okay, then you have to use acetylcholinesterase inhibitors in neurotoxic snake anti-snake along with anti-snake venom. There, neostigmin is the drug of choice. 1.5 to 2 mg you can give for the patient. But before giving neostigmin, you have to give atropine as a pre-medication with neostigmin. So in a neurotoxic bite, suppose the patient is having ptosis, respiratory paralysis, requiring ventilation, you have to give neostigmin 1.5 to 2 mg. Before that, you have to give atropine as a pre-medication. Otherwise, patient can have problems like severe bradycardia because of neostigmin. So you give atropine, neostigmin in a neurological bite. Okay. Now, other things, suppose the patient develops other things, suppose he develops bleeding tendency, you'll have to give FFP or FFP and cryoprecipitate depending on the conditions. If the patient develops a cellulitis, you'll have to give antibiotics. If the patient develops compartment syndrome, urgent surgical treatment is required. Okay, so we have discussed various types of snakes, various types of envenomation, the need of treatment, how we give ASV, what are the indications for neostigmin, everything we have discussed. Thank you.